Hey friends, so it's been a minute and I wish it hadn't have been a minute. I haven't filmed in like a week and a half and I've washed my hair like two more times since I filmed last, so my hair is a little bit more faded, but I like how it's fading. It's definitely fading a lot more gradually than if I was using like a really intense shampoo. So like the shampoo that I'm using is working and it doesn't feel like my hair is having buildup. Yay! Today we're gonna do a get ready with me and kind of just have it be like a casual chit chat, catching up, trying to hype myself up for a Capitol Hill block party. I'm not wearing any pants. It's very hot. I'm wearing my sexy Jeff tee, Jeff Goldblum, in honor of all the Marvel movies being announced, because holy fuck. I'm gonna be using the Midas Cosmetics Lemonade Palette today. I have been using this a ton the last week since I got it. I really enjoy it so far. These yellows are lovely. I don't know if I'll do the video with this, but I'm gonna do a sister does my voiceover. So let me know if you guys want me to use this or any sort of different palette, or just kind of have it be a generic tutorial that she does the voiceover for. But Libby and I are gonna try to do that in the next week or so. So that's coming up, but let me know if you want me to use this. Today we're gonna use it though. Yesterday was Capitol Hill Block Party and last weekend was Timberfest. So it's been a lot the last 2 weeks. I'm gonna spray my face with some. Oh shit, that feels so good. That feels so good. Thank you, lavender. Oh, why did I not keep that in the fridge? That would have felt even better. Yeah, it's festival season and it's heat season and I don't like it. Like last weekend was wonderful and lovely and I had a great time, and thank you for all of you who have left such like positive comments on the last video I posted. I kind of had no idea what I was in for when I posted it because I'm saying like negative things about somebody that people really like. So naturally the stans came out to play. So, you know, I pretty much spent the first few days of the week recovering from last weekend because it was very hot out at Timber and hot for me. Like Washington isn't actually experiencing a heat wave right now, miraculously, like the rest of the country is, but it was very warm for me and I got my period on Monday, so that one's really fun. So like Shark Week was upon me and it felt great. So it was like Shark Week, my body was tired. I had almost, it felt like a little bit of heat sickness because my body was like, hey, you were out in the heat for 3 days.
Why were you doing that?
And I felt gross. I was camping, but it was a great time. There were a lot of great bands playing. I'll include some video that I took at it. But those, I managed to get all the photos finished pretty quickly. I am gonna start doing live streams of video editing on Mixer here pretty soon. I just have to have my boyfriend help me set it up and really get like my streaming setup all figured out. This week was also the production week for the television show that my work does. So Thursday and Friday, we were shooting live music in my studio and it was a whole thing. And like, I had to go out and do a live shoot, like preparing for a live shoot over in Bellevue on a different day. It was just a lot going on this week and I had no energy to film, partially because I felt like garbage, was tired. It was really hot out, and like on the days that I felt like maybe I could do it, like my hair, I was just having bad hair days and it was just not a good week for me. And I'm kind of feeling that now. There's literally something in my eye. There's a planet in my eye and I cannot find it. So this week was not great. I'll just put it that way. And then somebody stole my laundry from my laundry in my shared laundry room in my apartment. So that was fun too. So like the two pairs of pants that I had and like one of my flannels just fucking gone. That was great. It was great. On top of what was already a fantastic week. Made my day going down to my laundry, waiting to get my jeans out because I did some laundry overnight and I was like, my jeans are missing. Those little irritants, those little annoyances that pop up in your day. yeah, I wanted to kind of catch up with you guys and see what was going on, let you in on what was going on, because I realized I've been off YouTube for like a week and a half, and that's not like me lately. Usually I'll go like sometimes maybe a week or so if a lot's going on, but like it's been a full week and a half because it's festival season. And yesterday, let's see what eyeshadow brush do I want to use. This one. Yesterday, I got to go to Capitol Hill Block Party for the third year in a row, and I'm taking the color Sweet. I think that's Sweet. Is that Sweet? Or is that Zesty? I don't know. This shade. Third year in a row, shooting Capitol Hill Block Party. Usually it's a great time. A lot of my friends play, like it's relatively easy to get to. You just drive to Capitol Hill, you park, and you're there for 8 odd hours. But yesterday was the first time I think I've ever seen like a fully sold out Capitol Hill Block Party, and Lizzo was playing, so obviously it was gonna sell out. It was a nightmare. It was an absolute nightmare. The crowd was huge, apathetic, pain in the ass. The problem was because so many people were just going to see Lizzo, they weren't really like going to see the other shows, so they're just like outstanding in the street, just like taking up space, and so like getting around anywhere was
horrible.
This year they didn't have like a separate entrance to the main stage for photographers, for those of us who didn't have pit access. So basically how festivals work is that when you apply for a press pass, a photo pass, you either get main stage pit access, which gets you kind of around everything, or you get kind of more generic press photo access, which gets you into the pit of every other stage, and you can take pictures of the main stage, you just don't get in the pit because there's like a specific number of people they can fit in the pit, so they have to do it for safety reasons. But last year there was like everybody could kind of go in this side entrance by the main stage to bypass crowd of people, because when it's in a city block it's very narrow, it's very long and narrow and crowded, so all these people in a city block, no other way to get to the front rather than pushing through them. So I'm going up to the front, I'm trying to get up for Lizzo 45 minutes in advance, I'm in this crowd of people, and just like the worst claustrophobia I've had in a very, very long time. Like, I didn't know if I would be able to get up to the front. Like, I felt like I was almost gonna have a panic attack, because I was just like, I spent 20 minutes just surrounded by people in a crowd, not being able to move very much. And like, one guy like looked up to me or looked at me and he was like, I was like being as nice as possible. And I was like, I'm sorry, press, I have to get up to the front. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Like, I apologized every single time I said, press, I'm sorry. And this guy looks at me, who's like,
well, you should have got here an hour ago.
And I was like, fuck off. I got up to the front. Eventually, I stayed for 3 songs because I was so upset. Like, I didn't have to stay for 3 songs. I could have stayed for more, but I left because I was so upset. And so I am trying to amp myself up for today. It's not sold out, so I'm using this shade now too, this brighter one. I'm trying to amp myself up using yellow eyeshadow and filming to make myself feel a little bit better, because today's not sold out, so it's not gonna be nearly as bad. But like, I don't know if I'm just like getting too old for festivals now, and I'm just like, it's not as fun anymore. But when it's that crowded, it's not fun for me. It's the complete opposite of last weekend. Last weekend was like out at a campground, 45 minutes outside of the city. It was really nice and chill. It's just like, you go into the beer garden, it's really laid back. Like, there was a mosh pit during the OCs, but like, that was it. Like, every other time, it was just like this really lovely, relaxed crowd. And it's the complete opposite of Capitol Hill Block Party, which is not that at all, not relaxed, especially when they have like a fuck ton of DJs playing. One of the guys that was playing was a rapper, and I don't remember his name, I think it was like Saba, and like he had his DJ, his MC up there before him, and the guy played 3 full-ass songs, like, you guys like J. Cole, and just like played other people's music for 3 songs, and I'm like, he played 2 songs, like, you guys want me to play another one? And I'm just like, no, I don't. I want the talent to come out. I want the rapper that I'm supposed to be photographing to come out and
rap.
Stop. So nothing against DJs, but it's not a dance music fest. I don't know. Like, I hate photographing DJ sets because it's very boring. I'm using this mustardy one now because naturally, like, I legit hate photographing DJ sets. I will put some concealer on. I like this yellow palette because it's like a really nice gradient of yellows. There's 3 different yellows on my eyes and I can see that. I don't know if you guys can see that on camera very well, but now I have, well, good thing I haven't put concealer on yet. I have yellow under my eye. Cool. I've just gone in very aggressively with this palette. It doesn't have that much fallout. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it. So, block party this weekend is just a weird time, to say the least. Because I'm just like, I want to get pictures of bands. I want to get pictures of artists. Get out of my way. And the security isn't making that very easy for people. Probably the worst part of last night was people who were trying to leave after the Snake Hips set and trying to, like, other people who were trying to get up to see Lizzo. So you have people in this very, very cramped space. Some people are trying to come this way and then other people are going that way. And there was, like, it wasn't safe. I'll stop ranting because it's a very me problem. It's a very, like, first world problem. Like,
oh, I couldn't get up to the front to see this artist that I got in to see for free.
I know I shouldn't complain, and I realize that, and I realize that I don't like to complain very often, but this just really put a damper on my weekend, to say the least. Anyway, other things, good stuff. Anybody else been keeping up with the Marvel Comic-Con things? Holy shit. I wasn't nearly expecting this much stuff for them to announce. It was like, oh, here's a movie, and then here's a movie, and then here's a TV series, and then another TV series, and then another movie. And it's just like, the fact that they announced this like all the way out to like 2021 is crazy, because it's like, wow, they have this all planned. I mean, I know it's Disney, they have everything planned. Because they know everything. Because Disney has too much intellectual property. The one thing that I, against my better judgment, support and see all of it is Marvel stuff. And I know that, like, Disney is, like, a big corporation, and I get that. But, like, holy shit, Thor, Natalie Portman's gonna be Thor? What? That's awesome. I'm so excited. Thor is my favorite Avenger, and like the whole Thor universe, like I love it. Like, I don't care how bad the first two Thor movies were. Ragnarok was perfect. Thank you, Taika Waititi. Thank you, Taika Waititi. I apologize if this video is like weirdly low energy, but I'm just having my cold brew now. But you know, what else has been going on? What else has been happening? Oh my God, did you guys see the, of course you saw the Cats trailer, duh. I watched the Cats trailer the other day and I already hate musicals. And if you wanna unsubscribe because I said I hate musicals,
that's fine.
And I'm speaking broadly, not every musical. I hate sing talking. I generally don't like show tunes and musicals that take themselves way too seriously. Not a super fan of. Like, Chicago is like violent and tongue in cheek. Hairspray, tongue in cheek. It has a message. I like it, I get it. I also saw Hairspray on Broadway for the first time. I didn't like the movie. I didn't like the Zac Efron movie. It was like fine, but I saw it on Broadway with the original cast and it was actually a good time. Like, I was 14 and it was like fun. Like, with the guy who played Mr. Shu from Glee was Link Larkin. What? That was fun. But like, and like animated Disney musicals, totally different thing. Sing talking. Why? This Cats musical trailer, I don't know a lot about Cats, both the animal and the musical, but I know that like it was pretty widely hated by the theater community. Like, correct me if I'm wrong, but the people who I'm friends with who are very into theater were like, yeah, no, like Cats is like, why? Like, people are like, wait, they're trying to give Cats a plot? Because apparently the actual like theater version of Cats, there isn't a plot. It's just people in cat costumes dancing around and singing songs. So like this trailer, oh my sweet Lord. Oh my God. Holy, oh, this is gonna be like a really yellowy under eye right now. Cool. Well, actually no, that's not bad. I just gotta like put on eyeshadow. I'm gonna do just this straight dark yellow under the eye. I watched it and I was like, wait, why? Gotta find my brush. It reminded me, this is total tangent now. YouTube recommended me this YouTube channel the other day called Corridor Crew that they do, they react to, they're visual effects artists and they react to good and bad visual effects and they like do little commentaries on it. So they've done like stuff from Avatar and then stuff from like The Scorpion King, which was like some of the worst CGI ever. So they do all these videos about CGI and like deep fakes and stuff. And I've been watching a bunch of their videos, and then the Cats trailer came out, and all I could think of is like, why would you CGI this? Like, why was this not practical? Why was this not a cat suit? And like, why do they have human feet? And like, it was just the weirdest trailer I have seen in a very, very long time. And I watched the Sonic trailer. It looks so bad. It looks so bad. I can't pinpoint exactly why the like CG looks so bad. Like I mean, I work at a production studio, and I mean, a couple of my coworkers know how to do some like After Effects, like graphic effects, digital effects. I don't do any of that, but like I see how much work goes into it and the amount of time and the amount of troubleshooting and the amount of like pre-planning it takes. Why would you not just put somebody in a cat suit? Like, why would you not just do like extensive makeup? It just seems like the biggest waste of resources to CG fur onto a person when like real fur exists.
Why?
Why? It was so bizarre. Oh, I'm taking this like kind of brownie shade on the corner here. It was the absolute trippiest trailer. And also the fact that Taylor Swift is in it. And I'm like, why? If that movie wins Oscars, I quit. I quit life. Like, if that movie fucking wins awards, nope. La La Land. This is just gonna be 5 minutes of me ranting about musicals. I hated La La Land so much that when I saw people talking about it, like I didn't see it before like everybody lost their shit about it. Like I didn't really care to see it because everybody kept telling me, oh, you have to see La La Land. And I'm like, no, I'm gonna do it out of spite and not go see it. So then when I finally saw it like on TV, it was at my mom's house, I'm like, why did this movie win all these awards? Like visually, it was absolutely stunning. Like from a cinematography standpoint, it was gorgeous. Production design, so pretty, so lovely. The songs were mediocre. Singing was mediocre. The plot line was non-existent. They were insufferable characters. And the opening sequence was one of the dumbest things I've ever seen in any movie ever. Because people would not be that happy in LA traffic. I don't drive in LA traffic, but I drive in Seattle traffic, and holy fucking shit, nobody would be singing in traffic like that. When I sing in traffic, I'm screaming along to Hayley Williams music. I am not singing show tunes on top of cars. Yellow on my eyes. Damn, Midas. You can make a yellow eyeshadow. Now I'm gonna do like a little bit of this in the center of the lid. It's like a very light gold shade. I like the tones in this palette more than the Honey one from ColourPop. I feel like the ColourPop one went too, because they did Honey, they went too like gold and not yellow. Does that make sense? Because this is like lemonade, it's more like true, just like yellow. But the Honey one, and obviously it had the like giant chunky glitter that wasn't eye safe. It's like, why would you put that in an eyeshadow palette, guys? Don't do that. Don't do that. And now to make it even brighter, I'm gonna take the, I want high voltage. Ooh, what if I did green? I'm gonna take high voltage from my Kleona highlighter palette. Ooh, that's fun. Ooh, that's fun. Okay. All right. Just add a little bit of green. So the lemonade palette, it has one shade in there that's more of like a greeny, limey lemon shade. I liked that the Midas ones went more true yellow and less gold. Even though there are some like goldy things in here, this is more of like a greeny brown, and this is like a greeny yellow. And yeah, I like it. I like it a lot. Good job, Midas. Is there anything else I wanted to talk about? I don't even know. This summer, well, let's talk about this summer. This summer is going to be, it's half over. That's the thing. It's like the summer is already half over, which is so hard to believe because July went by like pew, just so fast. But I have a wedding to go to in August. I'm going a bachelorette party I'm going to in the middle of August, and then a wedding that I'm photographing at the beginning of September and at the end of September. And I have a bridal shower. And I thought I was gonna go to another festival, this Thing Festival out in Port Townsend, but I have a bridal shower the same weekend with somebody that I've known since I was 7 years old, so I shouldn't bail on it. So, summertime is weird and I don't like it. I hate summer. I hate it I hate it. It's too hot. It's sticky. There's too much going on. I want my fall. I want, or autumn, as people in the UK are so adamant about it being cold. It's fall. It's fall. Sorry, not sorry. I'm gonna add a little bit of bronzer after I've contoured, just to warm it up. Because I'm not camping, I'm coming home at the end of the night, I can do more intense makeup. Last weekend, I did more just like, here's some makeup I can put on with my hands, and it's dewy, and it'll be easy, and it won't like wear off poorly by the end of the day, and it won't be too heavy. Today, I'm going, there's like some places that are inside, so I won't be like out in the heat literally all day. So now for my blush. How much powder can Abby put on her face? I don't know. This is the Hourglass blush, by the way. I've been using this a bunch lately to A, try and pan it, and B, it's really pretty. It's just so pretty and glowy. Am I in focus right now? I really hope so. Yeah, enough. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. I'm gonna use Electrocute because it's got like the yellow and the pink in it. Just a little bit. Cool. So I didn't wanna like sweat too much while I was getting ready because I knew that I would like super be sweaty later because I'm wearing pants because they're much more comfortable for my thighs. What else did I want to talk about? I feel like there were like so many things I wanted to talk about, but now my brain is just like, oh, it's hot. You don't know how to talk. You don't know how to think. You don't. I have just like palettes on palettes back here. I might do just like a little thing. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm doing something. No. God, what do? I don't want to put it under here. I mean, I could. No. No. Not gonna do it. Look at the stars, see how they shine for you. So the next video I am going to film is going to be my proper anti-haul for the month because it got interrupted by Lady Gaga being a damn fool. So I will be doing an actual anti-haul. I do want to do a video about my favorite YouTubers. So let me know if you would like to see that. That I'm kind of stoked for. Just a list of like people that I watch in different categories. People who are like makeup people and commentary people and comedy people and ASMR people. Because I watch a lot of different kinds of content on YouTube. Which I think is why I tend to like making my videos.
Not like the other beauty videos.
But you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I don't solely watch beauty content, which is like nothing against people who solely watch beauty content, but I think because I watch so much different kinds of content, people see different influences in my videos. Like I've had people comment being like, oh, you remind me of this person that's like not a beauty person, not a beauty YouTuber. Probably the most flattering compliment I ever get is people like, oh, you remind me of Jenna Marbles. And I was like, oh my God, I'm cute. I love her, she's my queen. Okay. Eyeliner is non-existent. This is mascara, Abby. What are you talking about? So I am gonna spray my face at some point. My spray is in the bathroom. But yeah. So was this all I wanted to talk about? Ooh, this is gross. I just needed to kind of get back into the swing of things and catch you guys up on stuff because this last week I just haven't been feeling great. And it doesn't help that like my sister and I are synced up, so we're both like equally as irritable at like the same time. She reacts like she has different sorts of symptoms of PMS that I do. She gets more bloated, like her body is more affected and my emotions are more affected. Like last night I literally just like was on my way home from block party and I just cried because I was just so upset by how the evening went. And like this week it also, something that wouldn't annoy me normally as much really set me off. Like the fact that my laundry got stolen, like pieces of my laundry got stolen and I don't know who did it. Thank you for being patient with me and for being generally understanding. You guys should, if you're ever curious like what's going on with me or if I haven't uploaded in a bit and you're like, oh, what's Abby doing? Like, what's her thoughts on stuff? Like, Twitter is where I'm the most active, like, lately, completely. Which is weird because for a while, Twitter was like a cesspool of terrible people. But I'm most active on Twitter and probably the most responsive on Twitter. Yeah, I use Twitter quite a bit. The day before Prime Day, on Prime Day, I was just like going off on people on Twitter. Just constantly just pissed off. Thank you everybody who's been so just like patient and supportive of me. Like, y'all are great. It's been a week. It's been a week. I don't know how people who can post things like every day. Like, I literally don't know how people are able to do it every day, multiple times a week. Like, how people can post every other day is so far outside of how I can operate. And I wish I could post more often for you guys. I wish I could post more, but I just can't, at least not right now, because it's so excruciatingly hot. I can't do it. Like, in the winter time, I can do it all the time because it's cold and it doesn't, like, my upper lip is sweating right now, like, just from filming, like, because of my light. So yeah, thanks for bearing with me. As far as song of the day, let's see, what have I been jamming? Oh, okay. Song of the day is Mountain by Spirit Award. Spirit Award played on my TV show, the show I work on, last month. And they're really good. They're good guys. They just got back from, well, they went on like a big old European tour a few months back. But they're super cool. If you like kind of psychedelic indie rock stuff, they're pretty good. Yeah, Mountain is dope. I like that song a lot. I've been listening to, honestly, to a lot of Paramore. A lot of Paramore, a lot of Metric as well, but particularly Spirit Award. I've been listening to that record, the record that Mountain is on, quite a bit. I'm gonna go try and handle today. Yeah, I don't know what's gonna, it's just, oh boy, it's really hot. Also, my body hurts. Okay, thanks to my patrons, y'all are great. Thanks to everybody who has subscribed lately, y'all are great. I'm getting real close to 32K. It's really exciting and cool. Please hit the subscribe button if you want to. I know this is probably not like the most exciting video, but it was mainly just to like catch everybody up and not just like jump straight back into like, here's another anti-haul after I posted a special anti-haul about Amazon and Lady Gaga. But that's gonna be the next video, I promise. Yeah, okay, bye.